Season?
I have. I think we've started to put down the foundation of who we want to be and what we want to be throughout the course of the year. James has done a good job bringing that change to our culture, and the guys are embracing it instead of fighting it. It's been hard work, but that's the only way we're going to get things done around here. So it's been refreshing throughout the first couple of weeks. A bit of both. Obviously, the results last year speak for themselves, and things didn't go well. And so James had to come in with a different group of guys, younger, fitter, faster, stronger group that is not afraid of challenges and not afraid of the pressure of playing for a team like Orlando with passionate fans and a city that expects results. It takes a unique type of person to be able to embrace that. Pressure, and that starts with us creating a culture that when we lose a couple of games, things don't fall apart and crumble like maybe they have in the past. And so that's the part where we're trying to really push ourselves to test ourselves in adverse training conditions and games, so that when we get in front of the cameras and our supporters, that things go the way that we want them to. Yeah, I think for me, things have always been the same with leading by example. James is the one who creates the philosophy and identity, but it's nothing unless the players embrace it and believe in it, which we do. We think he's onto something here. We respect him as our leader. And so guys like me who have been around for a while have to show the young guys how it's done every day in training, bringing it with everything we've got. And so for me, it just goes back to leading by example.
Well,
I mean, the easy answer, I think, is yes. Obviously, when good players leave, but those good players are going to be replaced by other good players. There's a lot of money out there. Teams are spending millions of dollars to bring in top talent. So while on the surface it might look like a few of our rivals have sold very good players, I guarantee you they'll replace those with equally, if not better, players. So then you turn back to yourself, and internally we have to understand that we got to control what we can control, and that's our group. That's our training methods, our methodologies, both on and off the field. And so when you start to do things like that, you can start to be able to compete with a real identity and a real culture shift that we're working on here.
We need to be blue-collar. We need to be humble. We need to fight for each other. We need to love each other. We need to respect each other and ultimately know that when we show up on a Sunday that every guy has the other guy's back. There's no one player who's bigger than the club. Everybody's treated equally with respect, and that's a good basis to start to build a foundation for a winning club.